DJ Architect is in the building.
Yeah, yo.
Killer B, so
yeah.
city in hoes. Stay on my pinos, cracking the goose, cause they funny like minnows. TV got you thinking you hard and on my dinos. You miss, girl, nigga, nigga, now we ain't gone, better chill out.
Authentic is the bomb, something like the boom. You got the red, the white, the blue. Who would be authentic is the coldest, and I'm never the boldest.
What about the DJ?
The DJ is going so hard, he's on the top, similar to God, yeah. And we do this, and we do it fluent. Authentic is the coldest, a positive influence, yeah.
Hip hop, detox, hip hop, hip hop. Hip hop, detox. Hip hop,
we say it.
Hip hop,
we say it.
Hip hop,
okay. Go.
Make some noise.
Yeah.
Pay close attention because you're about to hear. DJ Architect. What's his name, y'all?
DJ
Architect. What's his name, y'all?
DJ Architect.
Check out the skills, the first element of hip hop from DJ Architect.
Tell us about college, but not the finance.
Good, he's my teacher too then. I love having a teacher
because we all come into the world not knowing anything. But it's good to have a good teacher. Now, I want to make sure you all follow, because I know that where we're about to go is where we're going to need your help. Now, everybody say peace.
Peace
means positive energy always creates elevation. Everybody, repeat after me.
Positive
energy
always
creates
elevation.
Do your hands like this. Elevation. Now, if you say elevation, and you have to raise up your hand as you say it, that means you have to remember something very important. How many ears do you have?
Two.
I'm going to say it again. Excuse me. How many ears do you have?
Two.
How many mouths do you have?
One.
So that means that you have to try to listen twice as much as you. Twice as much as you. But you got to listen to the right thing. Because you have people today that's giving you the right thing. But the question is, as you get older, are you going to be able to follow it? And you can't be touching nobody right now because we gotta focus. Now, if we say peace is positive energy that always creates elevation, then what is this whole hip-hop detox thing? We said hip-hop is truth without boundaries. Truth without what?
Boundaries.
Truth without what?
Boundaries.
And the detox is to remove the poison. Remove the what?
Poison.
Well, some of you all noticed that the first element of hip-hop, we started with DJ. DJ. So the first element of hip-hop is DJ. But then the second element of hip-hop, when you hear music, you naturally may want to rap or sing or dance. So you got the B-boy and the B-girl and some people different forms of dancing, but it's natural to use rhythm when you hear music. Then the third element, you get what's called the MC. You're going to say MC. So when you heard phenomenal authentic rapping, that's the MC part. The fourth element, when you see people drawing on murals or walls, they call that what? Graffiti. The graffiti artists. The fourth element. But the fifth element of hip-hop, that's what we need for peace. See, if we got the fifth element, we can have peace. We need a certain science.
A certain what?
We need a certain knowledge.
A certain what?
To be at peace. Now, I want to do something with y'all. Is it okay if we do an experiment? Can we do an experiment? Okay, we're going to do an experiment. First of all, raise your hand if you have ever heard of a channel called CNN. It's a news station. You have heard of CNN? Okay. Now, I'm going to play something, but I want you to be a peacemaker and a peacekeeper. I want you to listen to what they say on the news, and I want to find out what do you think is necessary to make peace. Because sometimes we have arguments in our own families, sometimes in school, sometimes in our community, and we don't know how to resolve our problems, our differences, exactly. So everybody pay attention to the screen. I'm going to play a video of something that came on CNN regarding an issue that they reported on. And I'm going to make sure that we okay. Now, everybody listen to the report, because I want to make sure we look to see how we resolve problems as an example of real ways that we can help make peace.
However, there's something that can settle this debate of where the Chinese come from once.
Okay, ready? Okay, let's go.
The glamour, the dream of being China's next pop star. But Lo Jing's instant fame had its consequences. She was born in Shanghai to a Chinese mother and an African-American father who she'd never met.
Instant
He's like 1 year old.
So cute.
Growing up with a single mom, 20-year-old Lo Jing says she had a normal life, good friends, and only rarely felt out of place.
I need some okay back.
Sometimes people on the street would ask me, why do you speak Chinese so well? I'd say, because I'm Chinese. When Lo Jing stepped into the national spotlight on a Chinese reality show called Go Oriental Angel, she got attention not necessarily because of her talent, but because of how she looked. Hosts fondly called her Chocolate Girl and Black Pearl. The Chinese media fixated on her skin color. Angry netizens vented online, saying she never should have been born, and telling her to get out of China, sparking a bitter debate about race.
In many respects, China can be considered a very homogenous society. More than 90% of the population is Han Chinese. So people who look different stand out.
At first I cried a lot, she said. Then I got angry, and finally I just started to ignore it. Lo Jing's background became national gossip. Show producers convinced her mom to appear on air, the most private details of her life becoming painfully public. Lo Jing didn't ask me about her dad until she was 16, she told the audience. I cried, and she never asked me again. But as the show went on, so did Lo Jing, listening to Beyonce, her favorite artist, hanging out with classmates, and going to school. I was so angry, says her drama teacher, but she said she wasn't letting these things get to her heart. Fans continued to vote for her. The judges praised her confidence. Lo Jing was eliminated before the finale, but not without a powerful parting message. I think I'm the same as all the girls here, except for my skin color. We share the same stage and the same dream. Emily Chang, CNN, Shanghai.
傻瓜都一样。 Has anyone ever heard of this story? Or seen anyone ever seen this before? You have? Now, you all are the generation to give answers on how to make peace. What do you all think could have been done to make it where people, instead of arguing and fighting and maybe disagreeing, maybe they could have come together and, you know, not make an issue out of how someone looks? Because the real thing is who they are inside. How do you all think? Anybody got an idea of what could have been done, maybe? You do? Okay, I have one. I got one truth on the switch with you, and I'll take that microphone. Okay, so I had one over here. You stand up, please. Please give her a hand.
Yeah.
So, I'm going to bring the microphone over to her. Right there, hand up. Okay. Give your name and your grade, too.
My name is Shyla, and I'm in fifth grade.
Fifth grade? Okay, go ahead.
And it's not trying to be racist.
Say it again.
Not trying to be racist.
That's the first thing, is to work on not being a person to judge people based on the color of their skin. Please, give her a hand. There's sometimes a challenge to be the first one to shoot. There's somebody else who had their hands up as well. Who's that got their hands up? It was someone else who had their hands up. Oh, right. We have one, two, right. All the fifth graders, no, six, seven, eighth graders got something to say? Okay. So we're going to come over here. It's a third grader. Wow. The younger ones got to talk fast. Okay, go right here.
It's not a... Jada Lewis. It's not about the color of your skin, it's about your character.
Okay. Give her a hand. Okay. Again, one more. Shh.
My name is Nigel, and it's about who you are, not the color of your skin.
Okay, about who you are. Okay, please give her a hand. What grade are you in? Hey, please stand up.
Stand up and dance.
Okay. Your name?
Adonis McCoy, 8th grade. It doesn't matter what people think about you, just do what you do.
Okay, give him a hand. Okay. All right. Shh.
Yeah, one more up here. If there are any eighth graders, please let me know. Go ahead. Okay. Okay, well, definitely give her a hand. Now, everybody in here, if you were able to hear and understand what the CNN report said, raise your hand. You heard everything that they said in that CNN report. You understood. Okay, put your hands down. There were some people who did not raise their hand, which means you may have not either heard or you weren't listening very well to what was being said. But let me say this to you. If we want to make peace, you cannot make the same mistakes people made before you were born. And I hope you pay attention to what I'm saying to you. And be very clear on this. You are better than we are. You are another generation that can learn how not to make the same mistakes that your parents and your grandparents and your great-grandparents made. You can do better than us if you accept the challenge to be different and live by what is true. See, you have to discover the truth for yourself sometimes because we may not know. But you may be in a better position to find out what the truth is. Now, I'm going to play something. You have to listen very carefully. And some of you all in here, if you do not speak Chinese, you may not understand what is being said. So you have to listen to what's being said. Because I believe if we knew how connected we really are, we would not disrespect not only other people who got a different color, but sometimes we disrespect ourselves and we might be in the same family. So it doesn't even matter about sometimes where someone's from or what language they speak. Sometimes we treat one another bad because we don't love ourselves. But if you love yourself, you would do good for yourself. If you, if anybody in here loves themselves, say, I love myself. Okay, now if you truly love yourself, that means you would do good to other people. And you would treat other people right because you love yourself. But before we get any further, everybody pay quick attention. I want you to hear what's being said here. Shh. Listen up. Because this is something that the youth can actually build upon because it's based on truth. It's based on what? Truth. Listen up to show how we all are one. One family, one people. Listen.
However, there is something that can settle this debate of where the Chinese come from once and for all. I'm meeting Professor Jin Li, one of China's leading geneticists. Recently, he led a project which set out to prove that the Chinese evolved independently from everyone else, from Homo erectus, here in China.
Before the project started, I was hoping that I could identify or could be able to find evidence that supports independent origin of Chinese in China, because I'm Chinese, I came from China, and through the education process, I always believed that there was something special about Chinese.
He symbolized a male genetic marker, which only appeared about 80,000 years ago in Africa. So any man who carries that marker must have recent African ancestors and can't be descended from the more ancient Asian Homo erectus. Genetic DNA from over 100